In 1929, studio head Louis B. Mayer handed out the first Academy Awards. There were only 270 guests, the winners had been announced months before, and the whole thing only cost $5 to attend.
We have seen the American motion picture become foremost in all the world.
Fast forward 90 years, and today the Oscars are awarded in a 3,300-seat theater. Tens of millions of people watch the results live, and tickets cost hundreds of dollars. But the biggest difference? Today's movie studios spend millions to convince the Academy that their films deserve to win.
Sometimes the amount of money that a studio will spend when they're campaigning for an Oscar is even more money than the budget of the movie to begin with.
That's Kyle Buchanan. He covers all things Oscars for the New York Times.
If you want to get your movie taken seriously, you've got to spend. You've got to make sure that there are ads out there, that there are events, that people are contextualizing you as an Oscar contender.
And why do studios spend that much cash for an 8.5-pound statuette? For a smaller studio like A24 or Annapurna, the answer is pretty obvious.
They're making movies for, you know, not a big budget a lot of the time, but in order to be seen when the marketplace is choked with these big blockbusters and superhero films, they need that sort of extra headline-making ability that an award season can provide.
But what about a bigger studio, like Warner Brothers or Universal? As we've seen over the past couple decades, box office hits aren't often considered Oscar contenders, and blockbusters don't really need the exposure that a nomination brings. Isn't the money enough of a reward?
The people who work on these movies, by and large, are artists who want to be appreciated as artists by other artists in town. So when they are in contention for an Oscar, it means something deeper. It satisfies them in a way that money can't only.
So it's really about talent acquisition and talent retainment.
Yeah, it's about making sure that people are happy, you know? We see it all the time when a star has had success and then they want to do something more serious. They want to be understood as an artist with something to say.
Is that me?
When Warner Brothers goes all in on an Oscar campaign for Bradley Cooper, or Ben Affleck, or Clint Eastwood, it's not just for bragging rights, or even a box office bump. No, the studio spends that cash to show commitment to its stars, and to keep them coming back for future projects. For example, Hollywood's biggest studio, Disney, is pushing harder and harder for its top blockbusters to be in Oscar contention.
What next?
But the race isn't just between traditional studios anymore. So why does something like Netflix want to win an Oscar? I mean, it's already the talk of Hollywood. It's one of the biggest media companies on the planet. Why does it need the little gold man?
I think Netflix is eager to disrupt any industry it can get its hands on. You know, they've already changed the way that we watch television. Now they want to do the same for movies. Just like any studio, they want to be able to get in the Oscar race so that top-tier auteurs will come to them to make movies instead of the big studios that are out there. If they can penetrate this race, there's really nothing that Netflix can't do. They want to upend the idea of theatrical distribution being the end-all, be-all of seeing a movie. They want to change the way you see a movie. And if they can get Oscar to validate that, then they've gotten almost all the way there.
The Academy is getting younger and more diverse, and its nominees and winners are shifting too.
I think it's good and necessary to recontextualize what we think of as an Oscar contender, because it means that a lot of better movies that have maybe been historically overlooked by this season, but have certainly not been overlooked by audience members, can actually get into the race.
Over the decades, the Academy Awards have become bigger, more expensive, and maybe a bit more inclusive. But in the end, Louis B. Mayer started the awards to flatter stars into working in his movies. And today's studios will spend more than ever to do just the same.
When it comes to this town, when it comes to Hollywood, a lot of people go into the industry, or even before they get into the industry, they've stood in front of that mirror. They've practiced that Oscar speech. It is still the summit of this industry in so many ways, and a lot of people want that to really feel like they've hit the dream that they've always had. Thank you.